What we're showing here is an application of SimNet, which is a framework for running physics-informed neural networks on GPUs. As an example, let's take a look at how you can use SimNet to optimize the design of a heatsink. This involves solving a coupled fluid flow and heat transport problem. We've got a heat source in this chip on the board here, and a heatsink design on top of it that we want to evaluate over a number of different conditions in the chip. What we're going to do is search over a variety of different configurations of this heatsink. In this case, we've taken two of the parameters at the fin height. The center and outer fin heights are varied over a number of different conditions. We've also taken the volume of fluid in the metal, along with all of the materials that are in the heatsink and the surrounding air, and modeled them as a point cloud of about 3.3 million points. We then train a neural network on all those points using the various physical parameters, and map those onto a loss function governed by the partial differential equations of Navier-Stokes fluid flow and heat transport. The training takes about 4 days on a single DGX1. Once the training is complete, we can evaluate and explore 25,000 different various configurations in a matter of seconds. Here we are visualizing a subset of those. You can see the height of the center versus the edge fins are changing as I move these sliders, with the temperature map and flow instantly reflecting those changes. What we're looking for in this optimization problem is a condition where we've got minimum temperature for Tmax while still remaining underneath this gray plane here, which is the maximum pressure drop that our cooling system can provide. What we ended up finding was that the optimal configuration was not a completely rectangular block, but rather a roof structure. This makes sense because the heat is actually generated here in the middle, at the top of the chip. If you look at any other configuration, either the temperature or the pressure drops will increase. And finally, we are showing a simulation of transient flow with colored smoke vectors. The green vectors are showing flow that is slow, and the blue and purple vectors indicate faster flow. You can see here that there is slow flow through the core of the heatsink, but then there is very fast flow that comes over the top, which helps pull the heat from the center as it rejoins the streamlines on the other side. We can also turn off and on different layers of the simulation to literally see what happens when we change parameters, like the height of the fins or the pressure drop threshold. Note here that some combinations of parameters show what seems to be cool temperatures internally, but result in large drop in pressure on the backside of the heatsink. Using SimNet, we can see the effects of each change in real time, allowing us to quickly find a design that produces optimal cooling with acceptable pressure drops. Then we can quickly get that design into manufacturing, confident that it will perform as expected, the first time. These tools are something that we're using internally at NVIDIA to help model our heatsinks and do design space optimization. We expect to have a paper describing the core of the physics-informed neural network technology out soon.